Warning: the following video features information not gathered by a lawyer nor under the supervision of a lawyer. Accordingly, ASTV insists that no one attempt to recreate or reenact any points made in this video as the basis for a legal defense. I am not a lawyer. Don't smoke and drive.
After 6 months of intense debate, tonight, senators finally voted on the Liberal government's landmark bill to legalize recreational marijuana.
We begin with breaking news. The Senate has passed the Liberals' marijuana bill just now.
Canada has become the second country to legalize recreational marijuana nationwide.
And each province in Canada will come up with its own rules for the sale of pot. Uruguay was the first country to legalize recreational use of weed back in 2013.
As of October 17, 2018, cannabis consumption and possession will become legal in Canada. This video will focus on national laws based off the Cannabis Act. And for the love of God, don't try to use this video for legal defense, because I'm not a lawyer. By now, you've probably seen completely useless government commercials paid for by your tax dollars that tell you exactly nothing you need to know. So hopefully this video gives you some of the basic need-to-know info around the laws. The most pertinent definition in the Cannabis Act is dried cannabis, as it pertains to how much cannabis you are allowed to have on your person. It means any part of a cannabis plant that has been subjected to the drying process, other than seeds. Here are the most notable points for cannabis consumers in Canada. 18 years old is the minimum age to possess or smoke cannabis. In fact, in all provinces except Alberta and Quebec, the minimum age is 19. Subject to provincial or territorial restrictions, adults who are 18 years of age or older will be legally allowed to possess up to 30 grams of legal cannabis, dried or equivalent, in non-dried form in public. Now there's that dried definition again. We'll get to the equivalencies in just a moment. You can also share up to 30 grams with other adults, buy dried or fresh cannabis and cannabis oil from a provincially licensed retailer, grow from licensed seed or seedlings up to 4 cannabis plants per residence for personal use, and make cannabis products such as food and drink at home as long as organic solvents are not used to create concentrated products. Now, in terms of possession, the limit, as mentioned, is 30 grams of dried cannabis or its equivalent. So the equivalents to 1 gram of dried cannabis are 5 grams of fresh cannabis, which assumedly means not dried, 15 grams of edible product, 70 grams of liquid product, 0.25 grams of concentrates, solid or liquid, and 1 cannabis plant seed. Now, while there are no specific definitions of those terms that I could see, the example given is as follows. An adult 18 years of age or older can legally possess 150 grams of fresh cannabis. So given that these are the equivalent to 1 gram of dried cannabis, and the legal limit is 30 grams, to find out how much you're legally allowed to have, simply multiply the equivalents by 30 to calculate the legal limit. Therefore, for example, it would be legal to possess 450 grams of edibles, or 30 seeds. Criminal penalties. Possession over the limit results in tickets for small amounts or up to 5 years in jail. For illegal distribution or sale, you'll also receive tickets or up to 14 years in jail. Producing, growing, or cultivating above the legal limit, tickets or up to 14 years. And taking it across the border, selling or providing cannabis to a minor, or getting a minor to commit a cannabis-related offense, all of those are up to 14 years in jail. For information regarding specifics for each province, such as the laws or where you can buy, look in the description or simply search legalization followed by the province. For example, in Ontario, the legal age is 19, and new legislation has proposed smoking and vaping is legal in the following places: private residences, designated guest rooms in hotels, motels, or inns, residential vehicles or boats, scientific testing facilities, as well as controlled areas in long-term care homes or facilities. You cannot, however, smoke in indoor common areas like apartment building lobbies, places where children gather, like near schools or a park, and essentially anywhere you couldn't light up a cigarette. Whereas in Alberta, however, the legal age to consume is 18, you can smoke in some public areas, but edibles are still not yet legal to sell. Check out the link for your province in the description, read up, and share with your friends so they know the laws, and that way nobody gets fined for silly little things. And definitely, don't smoke and drive.